I don't really see this as being an RTS. I see it as being more of a real-time tactics game.
We quite literally are a Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter, but 50 times bigger.
Kind of dirt in the gears, kind of broken transmissions. We want it to feel like the sweat and the dirt and the stink of actually being out there, not some kind of pristine, idealized, kind of distant God view.
I mean, there's a number of things that we've done to make sure that the game is sort of very accessible but very deep. So the first thing is we've really concentrated on what are the core elements of the gameplay. And I mean, the list is, it's pretty simple really. There's what we call the combat chain, which is just like a real military units. You know, units are designed for different roles. They have certain predators that kill them and prey that they hunt. So helicopter gunships like the Apache are tank killers. Tanks are like heavy cavalry, so they can, you know, destroy lightly armored vehicles. Anti-aircraft vehicles are designed to take down gunships and so on. So that combat chain is a core part of the gameplay. Then we use cover, so you can move into cover, which is particularly valuable for infantry. You can garrison houses and so on. And then we have flanking as well. But really, just by combining those simple elements and the abilities of the different units, you've got an enormous amount of depth already when you do that realistically. And then our units also have morale, so they can actually break and run if they're outmatched. If they're getting really psyched up because you're doing well, they can really charge in to the enemy and so on. So you get this very organic, very realistic battlefield. But then what we've done, by putting more AI and putting more intelligence on the units, we can make the controls really contextual. So you don't have to exactly click and micromanage to this point. You know, you can go to your guys, unit three, move to alpha. They'll move to alpha, they'll take advantage of cover, they'll move into cover, they'll scan for enemies and so on. So we've really adapted the precision of the orders to focus on the interesting decisions, not micromanaging individual guys. And again, it's actually not that much of an innovation in the sense that that's exactly what you do with your squad mates in Ghost Recon or what you do with your teammates in Brothers in Arms. We're just doing it on this really massive, massive scale. And in fact, you know, in a tactical shooter, you're ordering those guys and you're fighting at the same time. The job for us is massively simpler because we don't have to worry about, you know, having an action game and the tactical game and juxtaposing both sets of controls. So actually our controls can be even simpler than a tactical shooter.